Well, darling?
Well?
Would you say the evening had been profitable?
I suppose so.
What's the matter?
Matter?
Yes, you seem odd somehow. Do you feel quite well?
Fine. I think I'll have a drink. Do you want one?
No, thank you, dear.
It's getting very chilly. Oh, my.
Charles. That was very clumsy, Charles, dear.
Oh, Vera, then it's true. It was you.
Of course it was. Charles, darling, Charles, what are you talking about?
Are you a ghost?
I suppose I must be. It's all very confusing. What do you keep looking over there for? Look at me. What's happened?
Don't you see?
See what?
Elvira.
Elvira?
Yes. Elvira, dear, this is Ruth. Ruth, this is Elvira.
Come and sit down, darling.
What do you mean to say you can't see her?
Look, Charles, you just sit down quietly by the fire and I'll fix you another drink. Don't worry about the mess in the carpet. Edith can clean that up in the morning.
But you must be able to see her. She's here. Look, right in front of you, here.
Look, Charles, if this is a joke, it's gone far enough. Now sit down and don't be idiotic.
Well, what am I to do? What the devil am I to do?
Well, I really think you might be a little more pleased to see me. After all, you conjured me up.
I didn't do any such thing.
Nonsense, of course you did. That awful child with the cold came and told me that you wanted to see me urgently.
It's all a mistake, a horrible mistake.
Stop talking like that, Charles. As I told you before, the joke's gone far enough.
I've gone mad, that's what it is. I've just gone raving mad.
Now sit down.
Why are you anxious for me to sit down? What good will that do?
I want you to relax. You can't relax standing up.
African natives can. They can stand on one leg for hours.
I don't happen to be an African native.
You don't happen to be a what?
An African native.
Has that got to do with it?
It doesn't matter, Ruth. It really doesn't matter. We'll say no more about it. Look, I've sat down.
Here, drink this. Would you like some more?
Yes, please.
Very unwise. You always had a weak head.
I could drink you under the table.
There's no need to be aggressive, Charles. I'm doing my best to help you.
I'm sorry.
Now, drink this, and then we can go upstairs to bed.
Get rid of her, Charles. Then we can talk in peace.
That's probably a moral suggestion. You ought to be ashamed of yourself.
What is there immoral in that?
I wasn't talking to you, Ruth.
Well, who are you talking to, then?
Elvira, of course.
Oh, to blazes with Elvira.
There now, she's getting cross.
I don't blame her.
Now, look here, Charles. I gather you've got some sort of plan behind all this. I'm not quite a fool.
Ruth, Elvira is here. She's standing a few yards away from you.
Yes, dear, I can see her distinctly, under the piano with the zebra.
But, Ruth...
I'm not going to stay here arguing any longer.
Hooray!
Shut up.
How dare you speak to me like that?
But listen, Ruth, please.
I will not listen to any more of this nonsense. I'm going upstairs to bed now. I shall leave you to turn out the lights. I won't be asleep. I'm much too upset. So you can come in and say goodnight to me, if you feel like it.
Well, that's big of her, I must say.
Be quiet, you're behaving like a gutter snipe.
That is all I have to say. Good night, Charles.
That was one of the most enjoyable half hours I've ever spent.
Oh, Elvira, how could you?
Poor Ruth.